What's up? This is day 249. Make it song, bringer. And today I'm gonna be drawing some more enemies. So I got this idea for an enemy. Let me run the game and show you what I'm talking about. This is a guy that is maybe like a little porcupine or something. He just shoots stuff diagonally like that. Let's go. Let's maybe go to this area. Run the same guy. Yeah. We should go there. Okay, so let me get this set up so we can we can work on that guy. For now, he's called AAA. Let's just do two of them. Put the player at this other area. And then, yeah, I think I'm going to start drawing a porcupine. Yeah, there we go. Cool. Awesome. What up, Chocolate Beer? Welcome, man. How's your day going? All right, porcupine time. All right, so I'm thinking he's gonna be mostly brown. Easy, nice. Easy day, cool. What's up, Tom? How you doing today? Oh, see, they have a little bit more of a white, like a off-white color. Look at this guy. I don't know if that's what porcupine's face look like. What up, Pedro? Pedro, teach me to say something in Portuguese. Man, I'm great. Yeah. Well, I got the other guys finished. Yeah, the other guys are looking great. Let's run around in God mode. I'll show you. Yeah, porcupine day. Let's go God mode, invincible. What do I want to know? What's the first thing I should know how to say? How are you? Hello? Hello, you can trust me. Get in my car. No, I'm joking. Oh, that guy got stuck. Oh, broke it. Invalid behavior, blob. Yes, Evermore. I'm trying it out. So I watched that last night. Did anybody know? Like, most people did not seem to know, but Bob Ross was not live. That was old recordings of his paintings. Hola. ¿Cómo estás? Hey, that's really close. That's really close to Spanish, which I already know a little bit. What's something else I should know? He did? What? I didn't know that. Yeah, that was not live yesterday. Bob Ross, not live. Most people thought he was live. They're like, Bob Ross is not checking the comments. Because there was like a bajillion comments. Even if Bob Ross was live. Live, I mean, as in, not alive. He got eaten by the Easter Bunny? Right? I'm late to a lot of things. All right, so what's this crash? Invalid behavior, blob, target, dir target. I got this blob. Blob, dir, target. That'll fix that. Yeah, right? Yeah, that would be great. Oh, you know what? I think I know one of the areas that has the, these going, guys. I'm trying to show you guys the finished, fans. What the heck? Oh, these are the other guys now. What happened to the fans? Oh, there's some. Here we go. Yeah, these guys are great. So when they walk in from off screen, they tend to do this, which is hilarious. They walk in a line. So some screens, they're gonna walk in from off screen. Some of them, they start on the screen. So one thing I could probably do to fix these, to make these guys even better, would be to make them to spawn them near obstacles. But it's kind of cute. It's almost like, why are they walking in a line, you know? It's kind of remarkable. So anyways, those guys turned out great. And the other guys too, the red guys bounce now. Yeah. What's up, Marza? Yeah, they turn out good. I like these guys. Let me see if I can show you the red guys. They bounce really well now. So no red guys nowhere. Oh, here's some. Yeah, so they bounce diagonally, right? So they reflect off of things that they bounce on. And actually, these are really cool to put like 99 of them on one screen. I mean, you'll die really quickly, but it's cool to see them all bounce off of each other. I'll show you guys. Let's save and quit. I'll put 99 of them. I guess so, sort of, yeah. So, all right, so those were the biags. Let's do 99 of those guys. What up? What up, Extreme? Yeah, right. So, yeah, Tom, you mentioned that the other day. Like, it would be cool if they bounced, reflected, right? Here's what that looks like with them all reflecting. And another improvement is that they start a little bit off, they're not exactly on a grid anymore. So if there's a ton of enemies like this, like a big mob of enemies, they'll actually, they'll look more natural when they start. And also you see they come to life more quickly. Before, it would wait a whole second between another one coming to life, another one coming to life, another one coming to life. Now, if there's a ton of enemies, they'll all kind of wake up quickly at the end there. So yeah. Alright, so I'm gonna get on to drawing this porcupine enemy first. Let's undo that. This area, yeah, we want two of those. And this we'll put the year to 12-4. Maxwell? Oh, I haven't seen that one. Maxwell. Cool, we're ready to draw these guys now. Is it this one? Oh, this is Scribblenauts. Is it this one? Oh, maybe this must be it here. Maxwell's Maniac. Sweet. Yeah, that does look very similar, right? Okay, yeah, let's start drawing. So I'm thinking this guy's gonna be a porcupine. Let's start drawing a porcupine. Let's get a porcupine color. Porcupine friendly color. Ah, this guy looks crazy in the dark. All All right, so I'm gonna start with this whitish color and we'll get a deeper color at the bottom too. Or maybe I'll start with this more brown color first. What did I do? There we go. All right. I love his legs. This might be a little too bright, actually. All right, so yeah, that looks like crap, but let's put it in and see how if it looks the right size. And anybody that wants to shout out what you think this guy should be named, please help me name this guy. We still live? What happened? Looks all right. Rossipine? I like it. I like it. Spiky pine? What's up, genetic species? Porky? Oh man, these are good names. Porky, Rossi Pine, Spiky Pine. Like Rossi Pine? I do too. Oh yeah, they're about the right size. Cool. Definitely too bright with that white. Actually, that white is kind of cool contrast. All right, we got two votes for Rossi Pine. I like it too. Let's call him Rossi Pine. In honor of Bob Ross. Okay, next up, let's get him blended right, shaded, and all that. Yeah! This is a really great emote. They did an awesome job on his fro. Nice. These quills have a really interesting color scheme. Yeah, I don't know if I like this whole making these pines look too striped. It's not really something that's coming across well with pixel art. Yeah, I like it. That neither. Okay, we're gonna make this guy totally different than an actual porcupine. Let's get some colors that are gonna work well. Let's create a palette. So starting from that, and we'll go brighter for his quills, and then deeper for his body. So let's get one darker color. One lighter color, really, that's all we need. Maybe darker than that. And what hue is this white? 42 is right in the orangish range. Yeah, that's great. Look, nature even does its, look at this. Look how nature does this art, these hues. All right, here's the hue of his body. It's more of a deeper red color, which is a deeper hue. And then as you get to this white color, this brighter, lighter, highlightier hue, it's just slightly lighter hue. As it goes towards yellow, it gets lighter in its hue. So that's pretty amazing how even nature does that. All right. I don't know. I might actually want to lead this white. Yeah, Senko, there's tons of AI already written. What's up, Doc? Dude, I'm doing awesome, man. Yeah, Henko, there's already behavior trees. This is the behavior tree for the enemy I'm working on right now. This is gonna be a little porcupine guy that shoots quills and stuff. So yeah, they already shoot their quills. There's many enemy behaviors, and they all use AI trees. So here's some guys that just bounce around, for example. They're really simple. Yeah. I gotta turn off God mode because that's why the player's moving so fast and running around. Right. Yeah. So there we go. How you doing, Doc? How's things going, man? This might still be a little too bright, these quills. What's up, Avenable? Welcome to stream. Yeah. Right on. What's up, Beta Barney? Welcome to the stream, man. Working on this porcupine-y kind of guy right now. Still needs a lot of work visually, but how about a sort of, if there's a slightly darker color to kind of imitate the same thing that's going on with a natural porcupine has sort of these like striated, like these little striped pines, quills, I mean. All right, man, yeah, cool. Is he looking good so far? So I'm gonna try and make these quills look a little more interesting, adding a little more depth by doing this with the stripes. These are gonna be fun to animate, you know? I can see them kind of like going like this. What's up, Robo dude? Welcome to stream. Oh, Doc, by the way, you might have already saw this, but I got a post written on Gama Sutra. So, you know, I'm trying to share this as much as possible because I really want this to help some people out there. I think this really is the cure for indie game failure. Just, you know, to test your game, prove that people are gonna buy it before you make it, before you spend the years to make it. And it's gonna work for a lot of different creative things. So anyways, I'm sharing that again. And yeah. Oh, all right, man. Well, yeah, I was just saying hi. He looks kind of rock, punk rock. What's up? What's up? All right, let's try him out. Oh, no worries, yeah. We need snakes and spitting cobras. Yes, we do. How did I get started with pixel art? I bought a graphics tablet. And this thing sat on my desk for a whole year before I ever used it. But during that whole year, I watched a lot of speed pixel art. I watched things on YouTube, just people making their art in fast forward, basically. Time lapse, if you will. Just, and that taught me a lot. It taught me how to do like shading and things like that. I didn't know I was learning, but by watching all that speed pixel art, I was learning a lot. And then later, when I finally actually picked up this graphics tablet and started using the pen and everything, it took a while to get used to it. That was probably that took the, you know, the most time. But once I was used to it, it was really easy. It just everything came really, really easily. And I think it was because I had watched so many speed art videos. Right? Yeah, I know what you mean. Yeah, I think a lot of people do that, you know, like you have some intention to do something for a while. Like I was always intending, like, man, I should learn how to make art. I've only been a programmer for, you know, however, my whole life. I've always been a programmer. And then I started making music and that was cool. And I thought, oh, this is neat. I know how to make music and program now. But being able to make art was the last bit that I needed to be able to be my own game developer without any outside assistance. And that's a really empowering thing. You know, once you're able to create games entirely yourself, you can do anything you want, anything. And that's incredible. It's an incredible feeling. And I want other people to be able to feel that too. If that's your thing, if you want to do that. All right. So this guy is now going to be called the Rossy Pine in honor of Bob Ross. And the screen we're working on here, get the Rossy Pine hooked up. And the Rossy Pine guy, his first frame, his idle frame, is going to be Rossy Pine East Zero. Yeah, I think his quills might be too light now, or still too light. Yeah, just a little bit too bright, I think. Yeah, what's up, Broba? You did? So how many people, was it still like an infinite amount of people like chatting at once? Yeah. So you guys know that he's not live, right? I was thinking, oh my gosh, he's live for a second. And I was like, why isn't he chatting? Why isn't he responding to the comments? But then I realized, I read all the info, and those are old recordings. Yeah, you can't see the second color. Yeah, I couldn't really see it either. Yeah, so let's fix that. And also the bright part of this white is a little bit too bright. You know, it's a little bit too wham, it's too neon, which doesn't quite fit the aesthetic of this game yet. 40,000 people, yeah. And he had how many million followers or whatever? But it's not really him. It's Twitch. It's Twitch's thing. Twitch did that. Yeah. Okay, so let's play with this palette a bit. If we darken this white, actually maybe we'll take, use that there and darken this. Nice, cool, man. Yeah, nice. Oh wow, was this weekend too? Yeah. So I'm trying them out with a little more darker quills. Yes, yeah, right? This is like it's almost like the fourth thing with making video games, right? You got programming, that's a skill in game development, of course. Artwork, music, and then business, I think, is a good quarter of the skills you need to have if you're going to be your own game developer. What's up, Rocket Bunny? Yay, I'm glad the stream's working for a lot more people today. I'm working on this porcupine enemy right now. Thanks, Puzzle Gamer. Nice, Avendable. Cool. Yeah, I really hope that helps, because, like, there's too many games out there that are great game ideas. They're great marketing, you know, they do a good job of everything they do, but somehow they fail, you know, and it's like, that doesn't have to happen. You know, I don't want other people to have to go deal with all that pain and suffering of freaking putting years of your life into something and then seeing it fail. You know, that shouldn't happen. That shouldn't have to happen. Okay, he's still a little too bright. Yeah, just a little. Still a little too bright. Sweet, man. Oh, yesterday's stream was crazy. Nobody was able to connect, really, because the Bob Ross stream was going on. And it's just, or something was going on. And yeah, Twitch was just horrible yesterday. So... Yes, there's one wild cinder block left, but I'm working on this guy. He will replace the one of the wild cinder blocks, and the next guy I'll get to in the second half of the stream, hopefully, and he'll be the other replacement for this. So I'm working on this first drawing of this porcupine guy. So once I get this dialed in, the art to look pretty good, then I'll animate him. So first thing is this first frame here. What's up, Kalame? Oh, nice. Right on. Thank you for... Oh, that's awesome. I was just asking about that. Thank you for mentioning it. Cool, Kalame. I'm glad. Thanks, Henko. Yeah, it's getting there. It's a little bit too bright compared to the aesthetic of the game so far. So I'm going to try it a little darker. Awesome. Good. Yeah. And especially Rocket Bunny for you, you're at where you're at. Like, oh man, I hope that helps you like to, you know, put you on the right path, you know? There, okay, now it's about right. It's not too bright anymore. Looks a little more natural. Okay, cool. Let's get this guy animated. Maybe a different color for his eye, though. How did it feel when I started streaming? You mean like a year ago? It was awkward. It was very awkward. It was very hard for me to code. You know, I've been a programmer for many years, but it was hard for me to talk and code at the same time. Making art was easy, you know, kind of. I had to really learn to talk, though. I had to, like, learn to say what I'm doing all the time. And at first, it was pretty annoying. I'm like, dude, this sucks. I don't want to have to just talk all about what I'm creating all the time. But, you know, after I got used to it for a minute, then it was okay, you know. And I realized that there was a lot of benefits to me talking and sharing what I'm doing programming-wise or art-wise to you guys. So it's, you know, and it helps me a little bit, too, to kind of, when I talk about what I'm doing, it helps me to kind of almost step back from the painting a bit, you know, or step back from the code a bit and realize what's going on, the bigger picture, you know. Yeah, I'm not really intending for them to look perfectly striped. I tried them darker and it didn't really fit. So that's not really a big concern. I don't think. Let's get a totally different hue for his eye. Maybe pink or red or blue or green. Yeah, he looks like kind of evil now. And let's play around with this and get a few spotted spots going on or something. Oh, soccer? Yeah, definitely. Talking keeps people energized. Keeps myself energized, too. No, I'm from California, but... no. Yeah, exactly. You're from anywhere else, yeah. No, I don't watch soccer or football or much. I love sports. I think they're awesome, and I love playing them, and I love watching them. But I just don't have time as a game developer putting, you know... 12 hours in a day at least making this game. I don't have time to watch stuff or follow sports. What's up, Valveware? Yeah, I kind of like him with this green eye. It looks cool. Yeah, all right, let's get him to what, like, start walking now. Maybe actually she have 2 feet, so like a darker color for a back foot. All right, yeah, I think this looks pretty good to start. Nice, right on, man. Yeah, cool. What's up? I'm making some art for these enemies. I got four different enemies I'm creating this week, and then later this week, I think I'm actually going to start a new dungeon. Yeah, right on. The ultimate combo, right on. Nice, right on. Yeah, I mean, it'd be cool if it did give some coverage, but really the point is to try and spread this idea throughout the game development, and just, especially the indie scene, all other indies, I would love to be able to just not have them have to experience the failure that I've experienced and many other people have experienced. There's too many indie game failures out there. So how can we solve it? Hopefully that this spreads a bit, this idea. And it's not my idea, this is, the idea has been around. I guess I just put it into words. So I hope that helps people. Oh yeah, right on. Yeah, hopefully your college has the right enough internet to be able to do that. Wait a bit. How did you come up with a name for the video game? Talking about the video game in general, or this little guy here, or what? Okay, let's animate him. Let's create a video frame. All right. Oh, okay. One last test. Let's see what he looks like with that green eye in the game. The Bob Rossi Pine. Oh, Wizard Fu? Oh. It's from Kung Fu. Yeah. Pedro's got it right here. Yeah. Thanks. Thanks a lot. The only problem with the name Wizard Fu is that some people think I'm trying to say FU at the end. But no, it's, I mean, some people I probably would want to say that to, but no, it's really just Kung Fu with for wizards. You know what I mean? Wizard Fu. It's your wizard powers, man. Yeah, cool. I love his green eye. Just that one little tiny dot of color. It's different than the other colors, really helps him. So now it's gonna be fun to animate his movement because that'll really make him come to life. So let's do it. And get rid of this. I don't need this palette anymore. Nice. How do behavior trees work? That's a. I can kind of explain it quickly. Yeah, Azuras, new enemy. Behavior trees are pretty simple. They let me explain it with actually looking at the behavior tree. A behavior tree is something that it starts off like it starts processing the behavior tree, right? And when it comes to a select, it's going to choose one of the things underneath it. So it's either going to choose this sequence, that sequence, this sequence, or this sequence. Everything inside a behavior tree can return true or false. So this sequence right here, as a whole, it can return true or false. The sequence returns true if a sequence has to run everything in order and all of them to be true for this sequence to return true. A select returns true if any one of the things inside returns true. So a sequence goes, okay, if target none. If that's true, then it proceeds to the next thing. Okay, target the nearest friend. If that returns true, then this whole sequence returns true, and then the select will also be done, right? But if anything in this sequence returns false, then the select is going to move on to the next thing, which is this sequence. And if anything in this sequence returns false, it goes on to the next one, and then the next one, and the next one. So that's the simple rundown on how behavior trees work. If you want more info, just look up behavior trees on Google. Yeah, blinking too. Nice, yeah, for sure. Yeah, he'll blink when he turns a bit, maybe or something. Okay, so this is gonna be the middle frame, right? He's like at rest almost right here. Let's make a frame where his legs are moving and his porcupine quills are bouncing a little bit, his head moves a little bit, his tail moves a little bit. So this is going to be the second, the first, yeah, the second frame, he'll have his first leg forward. With what language or framework do you use for behavior? Yeah, so behavior tree is just like AI. It is a subset of a state machine. I'm using the same language I'm using to make the game, which is C++. I wrote my own framework to basically process behaviors for this game, and I published part of it. It's called Valtree. It's on GitHub. I've published two things for this game actually so far: Valtree and here we go. This last one. Now we use Valtree. So there's Valtree. This processes that data really is all there is to it. But the rest of the state machine, behavior tree, behavior, and all that is really specific to my game. There's no way I can really share that. So there's that. Oh, sorry, I posted the wrong link. Sorry, that wasn't it. GitHub, Valtree. Why didn't I copy paste? Right. There. There's that. All that does is Valveware tree. You should make one. You should make something called Valveware tree. Okay, so his first, this second frame, his right foot's gonna go forward. His head's gonna turn a little bit to the side. So it's probably gonna squish a little. Yeah, it looks good, actually. Maybe something happens there with this front of his body a little bit. Like that, maybe. Hello, Pizza Champ. What's up, man? Welcome to the stream. Okay, and his back leg's gonna go backwards. And then his middle leg here goes forwards. And you're gonna see his back leg or his front left leg come back a little bit. All right, so there's that a little bit, right? Just kind of moving his body to the side as so he's got his front right leg forward, his front left leg back a little bit, and is the opposite going on with his tail. So his tail is gonna move, squish a little bit too. And let's make his porcupine quills bounce. Okay, so it's hard to tell if that's gonna look right until you actually see the animation in process, but we need the last frame for that to work. So let's go on to moving this, doing that last frame. It's pretty simple animation, it's just four frames. Okay, so yeah, this one, his front leg comes backwards. This leg goes forward. Yeah, I like him like that with a tinier leg. That leg goes backwards, this leg comes forward. Soundtrack? Nice, man, for the game. Cool, glad you like it, man. It's getting better. I'm a very iterative type of developer. I take things and then make them a little bit better, a little bit better, a little bit better. Day by day, it gets all a little bit better until finally it seems a lot better. You're like, whoa. So what's that saying? A programmer underestimates, no, overestimates how much they can get done in a day. So true. And overestimate or underestimates how much they can get done in a year. I finally come to realize just that I can get a lot done in a year. Okay, so maybe this is where he blinks his eye. So we'll put a little darker green for that. Or probably not, actually. Yeah, something like that, where he's got his eye totally blinked. Thanks for following, by the way. Oh, did that? Does Jib still look good? Does Jib look all right? Scanning. I got a dark face again. Turn the lights on. It's been cold here. It's freezing cold. It's a cold snap going through the west coast of the Americas. It's hard to let go. What do you mean hard to let go? You mean hard to let go of the last iteration? Sweet larvark. Yes, exactly. Yes, Azarus. Cold for us is like summer anywhere else that's cold. What's up, Junior? Why am I standing? Because it's better for my spine, and I find I have more energy, and I need to do it for a few hours a day. So I just do it while I'm streaming. Oh, yeah. Oh, I was talking about iterative as far as developing one game, though. You know what I mean? Like, with this particular game, Songbringer, I spend a day, right? And I get a little bit done, and it makes things a little bit better. The next day, it gets a little bit better. The next day, the game gets a little bit better. So it's an iterative process over the game. At first, the game looks like crap, and then eventually, the game starts to look okay, and then it looks a little bit better, and eventually, it becomes finished, and then hopefully it's something good. Yeah. Well, you don't need one, Valware. I don't even have a standing desk. I'm actually in a closet. Let me see if I can turn things a little bit for you. But yeah, I'm actually at the very top of a closet here. I just have things set up at the top of the top shelf, and then I have my stuff I use to code and make art and stuff down there. So, yeah, it doesn't have to cost money to make a standing desk. There's a pen. Will the game go to iPhone? Yes. It's already confirmed going to be on iPhone and iPad. Yep. Possibly Android. I'm not sure about that. We'll see. And possibly PlayStation 4 and Xbox. We'll see about that too. I'm going to be registering as a developer for that, or I might go with a company that ports it. So, yeah, that'll be some exciting times to see what happens there. All right, and then the same thing happens with his tail. Comes in like one pixel here. Okay, we're ready to try it. Yeah, right. Makes it easier to spot bugs earlier on? I guess so, yeah. 'Cause yeah, you each day you get a little bit different. Sammy Lots, is it comfortable to work standing up? Yes. Yes, it is. At first it wasn't, of course, but for an hour it was, For an hour you can stand up, right? So that and that's how it was for me. I was like, man, this is tough to stand up for more than an hour, but I can at least do an hour, and that's how it was at first. And then as I got more and more used to it, it's actually more comfortable for me to stand up and work than sit down sometimes. Because I don't know about you, but I don't have much of an ass. Like my butt is so small. So when I sit down for too long, I get really sore in my butt. It's like, dude, I could do anything but sit down at this point. So standing up is actually more comfortable sometimes. Yeah, I've seen that. Yeah, that's pretty cool. I posted to that one time. Yes, Rocket Bunny. Yeah. Yes, I would. And I've got all my videos up on YouTube of every day making this game. And if you go back to the very first videos, let me get you the link to like the very first video. Here's making Songbringer the playlist. Yeah, here's all the way back to day one. Wait, oh, there's a lot of these, huh? Here we go. Walking East animation. This is the first day of making this game, and you can see I'm working on very basic things like collision and stuff like that. So there you go. Yes. Yeah, nice. Nice, Pedro. Yeah. Yeah, I've seen those. Those are pretty cool. Yeah, right? Huh? What's that? Oh. Okay, yeah, so you see how this looks. So there's one frame, there's another one. He's gonna go back to this middle frame here. And then this last frame. And then this frame. What's? Oh, I messed that up. Okay, there's that frame. The second frame, the original frame, and then the third frame. Ah, he's kind of fast, but that's actually looking pretty good. Yeah. Oh, so there's a problem with his front leg. It's not moving. I think this first frame, he shouldn't have that front leg at all. Maybe just like that. Yeah, now it looks a lot better. Siri, did I send the wrong link? Oh, again? What's wrong with my co Oh, sorry. Now I see what Azrin is saying. Sorry. Thanks, Valware. I don't know what's up. I press Control C. I swear I press Control C. Yeah, I didn't. That happened twice on today's stream. I don't know what's up. It can't be my fault. It's not my fault. Okay, yeah, I like this guy. Let's see what he looks like in the game like that, walking around. I'm not sure about his blinking eye, though. Oh, and I'm gonna touch up this one little bit right here. Yeah, I think this, I don't know about his blinking eye. And this, like that. Also, this bit here. I know, right? I grew up using Windows, so. Right? His face gets pushed in, so his eyes to close without blinking is better. Huh? So you liked it better with the blink? His butt, his tail needs to move a little more, his butt. Yeah, that's a little better. But not, oh, this one little, there's one little pixel that's off again. This right here. And this last one. All right, there. This doesn't, I don't like that pixel being there. Front leg looks weird. Yeah, maybe it does with it without that extra pixel. No, that doesn't work. Maybe like that. No, that doesn't work either. No, I liked it better the other way. It's one of those decisions where it's like it's pixel art, so it can't be perfect. Oh. Okay, let's try this out though in the game. Let's see what it looks like. Because, you know, things can change once you put it inside and you put it in the context of everything else. So he's getting a run animation now. Oh, I think I might have messed it up. Yeah, this is supposed to be 0.01. Render this again, east, yeah. Sweet, glad you guys like it. Let's see what he looks like in the game though. Once he's in the game, then you can know if he's cool or not. You can tell. Why doesn't he work? He's not walking. Why don't you want to walk, man? Don't you want to walk? Another thing, he shouldn't pathfind if he's only going to be east-west the kind of guy. No pathfinding. What happened to that? Run, format, Rossi Pine, east. It should be okay. What's up with that? RoboDude, do I work full-time? Yes. Yeah, this is a full-time thing ever since the Kickstarter. actually before the Kickstarter. Before the Kickstarter, it was full time, and I was using my savings and stuff and credit cards basically to keep on working on this. And then because the Kickstarter succeeded, I was able to actually continue making this full time. So thanks, Microdust. Can I zoom in? No, I can't. What's up with this? Frosty Pine East? That should have worked. Whoa, what was that noise? East 0, East 1, 2, 3. That should be good. What am I missing here? That's so crazy. Oh, I've hosted. Awesome. Arconix, thank you, man. What's up, Lindsay Likes? Doing great, man.
What's up, baby?
Thanks, Arconix. I'm working on it. Yeah, but cheers. Thank you for hosting. It's really nice of you. So I'm working on, anybody that's just joined the stream, I'm working on a little porcupine enemy here. This is the game. It's called Songbringer, and it's like Zelda 1, but procedurally generated. So I'm working on this little porcupine enemy here. And he's supposed to walk, but he's not walking. He's not doing his walk animation. He's just over it. He's like, no way, I ain't walking. You want to see me walk? No way, dude. I'm not going to walk. Here comes the famous debug. How do you debug? Hopefully you can use your intuition. RoboDude. Oh, yeah. Sorry, man. RoboDude. Yes. This is a full-time thing. I work on this full-time. And I started full-time. And I was using my savings and credit cards to do this. And then because the Kickstarter succeeded, I was able to continue making this game full time. And that's awesome. No, it's not a still image, drunk chimpanzee. This is an animation here. See this? I just got this animation going and it's exported all these frames. And now I'm like, why didn't it actually work? Run usually works. What happens if I take away both of these? Yeah, no, I added a drift. Yeah. How do you like that? Yeah, it has not always done that. It's been recently that I added that camera drift. So I tried taking away. Yeah, see, now he works. Okay. It must have been his allowed compass directions or something. But now, see, it gets crazy when he starts to go in a diagonal direction. Oh, wait. See, he worked at first, and then he stopped working. What's up with that? Why don't you want to work today, porcupine? This is crazy. So if I put that back in. No, I do not have a co-worker. That's my fiance. Oh, there. See, he's walking now. And then, oh, as soon as he shoots, he stops. Oh, okay. It's because he shoots. So let's try this. If I take away the animate shoot. Because he doesn't even have a shoot animation. And I'm going to turn on the frame rate down a little bit because it's hard for my computer to stream and run the game. Yeah, you're right, blinded eye. That's probably what it was. I think it was the shoot animation. Yeah, that's my fiance there. Porcupine. Exactly. There we go. Okay, now he's working. Yeah. So he was trying to run this animation he didn't have. Okay, cool. All right, yay, we got him working now. It would be great if he had an actual shoot animation though. So when he launches the four rocks or darts, whatever the hell those are, I'm gonna change those. Those are gonna be different art. But now let's make an animation so when he does that, he does a shoot, he like maybe like hunkers down a little bit and like, you know, gets in the shooting stance or something like that. Yes, it was the debug moment. Yeah, glad that's working now. Awesome. Okay, now we get back to actually making the art. So, okay, I'm going to save. Let's get rid of this inspiration image here. Let's save this as Rossupine. This is the Bob Rossupine, you guys. This is in honor of Bob Ross. Rossupine shoot. East, sure. Okay, let's save that. And then now we can create it's going to be a single animation, single frame animation, really easy. Here's that other animation in case we need it. And let's get this one. Thank you. Rage Paint. What's up, Rage Paint? How you doing? It's been a minute since I've seen your name on here. Yeah, thank you guys for hosting. Thanks, Last Talon. Okay, so this is going to be a very simple one-frame animation where he tucks his head in and he shoots out, like, you know, his porcupine. So his quills are going to kind of, like, go straight up. His head's going to kind of tuck inward. This would be a really good frame for him to close his eyes, too. Yeah, man, it's going great. Thanks for hosting. Thanks, Valware. Thanks, everybody. I appreciate all of your sharing and stuff. All right, so yeah, let's get him to, his head's gonna move downward a little bit. And he's gonna squish inward a little bit. Yeah, that looks good already. His tail, same thing, like he's gonna tuck his tail in a little bit. And his quills are going to go straight up. Some of them. Well, maybe not all of them, actually. Kind of looks odd going super straight like that. Drunk Chimpanzee, how much am I done with this game? About 50 to 60% done. Yeah, I started this game in November of last year. It's now November of this year, so it's been almost a year. It's been about 11 months making it. It'll probably be another at least 6 to 9 months making it. So it's going to come out sometime in 2016. I'm not exactly sure. Maybe June, maybe April. It depends on how much I can get done in the meantime. So we'll see. If I can go, I would love to be able to go all the way to June, but I need the funds to be able to do that. So I think I'm not sure what I'm going to do about that. I think he's going to kind of like go down a frame. Like his whole body squishes down a bit. Let's try that. And is more of these quills standing up. Thanks for following, you guys. Okay, let's try that. Let's see what that looks like. This is his shoot animation. Save out this one frame. The Bob Rossupine shoot east. Christmas. Yes, yeah, it's coming out on Steam. The price is going to be around $15 to $20. I'm not sure where in that range it'll be. But let me give you the link. Let's see if I can actually copy-paste a link correctly today. Here's the link on Steam. It's already there. But yeah, you can chat with me here on Steam. You can wishlist it. I'm trying to be as active as I can on here. Yes, I look at that. I copy and pasted a link correctly today. So the control C, command C, command C does work. Okay, I think we're ready to hook this up. So he needs the his animation hooked up in a profile, in his profile. So the Bob Rossupine. We should just call him Bob. Yes. It's remarkable. It's amazing. Control C, Command C. Whatever you want to call it. It does work. I can confirm that it works. I think this animation is called Shoot. I'm not sure though. I know another guy that works like that is the Drolete. So the Drolete has an animation. Shoot, yeah, okay, shoot is the animation. That's all we need. It's just something called shoot. And I don't think the Drolete calls the shoot animation. Oh, it does animate shoot there. Okay, we might need to call that then. But that should work now that that's hooked up, the shoot. Let's see what happens. Hopefully, it doesn't need that. All right, see you, robot. Robo dude. All right, if anybody just joined the stream, I'm making a little porcupine enemy today. I already got his behavior done in a stream earlier this week. That was the code part of it. This is more of the art. I'm making art and like today. Yeah, he doesn't do it. Okay, so he does need this animate shoot line. Hopefully that doesn't mess up his walk this time. But now that he has this animate or this shoot animation, hopefully he goes smoothly between the two. No, he doesn't like it. What's up? You don't like the animation? Oh, did I, was that, was I supposed to make it a zero? Oh, pff, duh! I didn't even. Dude, this is one of those days where I'm just. Nice. Is it all right if you just add me? I'm not super duper familiar with Steam or whatever. So if anybody's wants to add me on Steam, how do I get to that again? I think you just go to my profile, right? Is that how it goes? Here. Here's me on Steam if anybody wants to be my friend. I did. What's that? Valware? What'd you ask? Sorry. Sweet Total Sketch, glad you like him. Sorry, Valware, ask again. What was that? Okay, now this should work, right? Now that I hooked that up right. Hopefully that's good. So, yeah, I'm making this porcupine enemy right now, and hopefully I have enough time to make a tentacle enemy today, too. Oh, we didn't like that, so something messed up with I think that animation file. Yeah, it does not like this render system set frame. Yeah. Oh, frames dot size? Let's fix this. This is a total bug, so I need to fix it real quick. Oh, Valveware, this is an excellent question right here. This is something I meant to put into that article on Gamma Sutra as well. But I just found that I really couldn't come up with a good enough way to tell people how to set that for themselves or whatever. Couldn't really share it in the Gamma Sutra. But how did I determine my goal for the Kickstarter? I went with the bare minimum amount that would get me to where I thought I needed to go. So I thought the bare minimum for this game would be 6 more months, and I needed $1,500 a month. So 1,500 times 6 is $9,000. That's how I set my minimum goal. But it turned out to be not quite enough. You know what I mean? I underestimated how much this project would need. Because, December is next month. That's when this game should have, I thought it should have been released, right? Next month. But it's going to be at least another 6 months. So I should have set my goal higher. And yeah. So I don't know. I mean, it's really hard to say, right? But I don't know. It's kind of up to you at that point, you know? How do you determine how much you need for on from a Kickstarter? It's really a very personal or yeah, it's kind of a personal thing, I guess. You just kind of got to do it on your own. So yeah, this quills. Yeah, drunk chimpanzee. That's what I was thinking too. The one problem with the we're using his quills as an as his projectile would be that they might be a little bit too small. So I might need to just make them super big or something like that. I don't know. Nice. Right on. Well, yeah, I just gave you the link there if you want to add me or whatever. I'm not sure how to add people based on their names and stuff. I'm still kind of new to Steam myself. I know how to play games, of course, but I don't really the community part of it, I'm still learning. So, oh yeah, this part right here, if frames, I think if this is a bug, it was going on right there. Frames dot size, return. That'll make it so it doesn't mess up there. Let's verify that by running it again. And I think it's loading the wrong animation or whatever, so that's why it's getting to this little bug here, this problem. So this should make it so it doesn't crash this time. Oh, right on. Oh, you sent a friend request to me. I get you. Okay, I see what you're saying now. Thanks, man. Yes, good. Okay, it's not crashing anymore. So there, that bug is fixed, but we still need to get his shooting animation to work. Rossupine, he's got Rossupine shoot east. And the actual sprites. My God, there's no scroll. Oh, it's up there. That's a bug. Ross. Oh, I forgot the zero. Okay, let's fix that. Sheets, Rossi Pine, Common R, no. Foes R. There. Now we should have that animation. Yeah, Yes, right? Yeah, this is what's so hard about it. If you go too low, you're not gonna make it, but if you go too high, you might not make the actual goal. That's why I really didn't include that information in the Gama Sutra post. I just didn't know how the hell to solve that issue. Awesome, chimpanzee. I'm glad you like that, man. When I started streaming a year ago, I just thought, I'm gonna be however the hell I am. This is how I am. I want to meet people too, right? I get lonely making my video games, so it's cool to be on Twitch and like, sharing with you guys because especially because you guys understand what the hell's going on. Not many other people I know understand coding and understand pixel art and all and games. I'm watching this top guy, but he's not shooting. Oh yeah, he shoots. Okay, let's zoom. Let's make him pause for a second longer when he does that. So, where is he at? Rossupine. Shoot. Let's make his delay with this shoot. Wait a minute. This is supposed to be two for that too. Maybe he'll look better when he walks now. Yeah, I like that. I like that a lot. He's like, blam, blam, blam. Cool, I love it. Okay, next thing is to make give him a dying animation. So right now he turns into the cinder block. But let's get him, and let's give him some more health too. He's like way too weak. Like at least 3 health. Yeah, totally helped with that extra 0.1 seconds, right? You have issues with the frame buffer for your shadows. I tried to implement one frame buffer, not for shadows, but for lights. But when I try to draw it on the screen, it seems like only one pixel from the whole frame buffer is drawn. I'm really lost. Did I have an issue like that? Do you have any advice for you? Avery Monster, this is really hard for me to answer your question without knowing your game engine to start with, but yeah, man, this is so hard to like try and help you with that. I don't really have any general advice on that. Try and help me out by telling me more about your situation. Tell me about what engine you're using, what platform you're on. PETA, what's up, dude? Welcome to the stream. Yeah, you're happy about the cinder block, right? Sergeant Sir, yes, I think it's based on your graphics card and how much memory it has. But I think there's a way that OpenGL can put some memory in your computer's memory and some on the GPU. I'm not sure if that's correct. I don't know. I'm not exactly that much of an OpenGL expert, so I really can't answer that. Yeah, what's up? Welcome, PETA. I'm working on this porcupine guy. The next thing here is to get him to die and look, do something when he dies. So what should I do? Should I have him like fall over on his side? Should I have him curl up into a ball? Should I have him get thrown into the air? What should I do? And when this guy dies, what is he going to look like? I'm taking shout out suggestions here. Yeah. How long have I been streaming? Hour and a half. We got a half an hour left. Looks like I might be only able to make this one guy today. You want him to go into a ball? All right. Yeah, that's what I thought. I thought you could use your computer memory somehow. That's an interesting idea, Arconix. I don't have any enemies that do that yet, but it wouldn't be too hard to implement. Quill explosion on death? That's an interesting idea, too. I like this idea of if there are quills, they should definitely get stuck into walls and stuff. Okay, you're the only one that voted for him falling on his side. I'll have him curl up into a ball. This whole shooting out spines or maybe being a hazard, I'm not sure if I'm able to actually do that on today's stream, but I like that idea. Both those ideas. You burn up in a gas cloud. That sounds that'd be easy to do. It'd be easy to draw. All right, so we're gonna save this as his dying. I'm always calling these things release animations. It's kind of my format for this project, but the other day I'm like, why the hell am I calling it release? Okay, so yeah, let's make him curl up into a ball. Oh, that's a good idea, Azmaris. I would love to have an enemy like that. You can't really kill him. He's plot twist. He's Doctor Who. Yeah, Rocket Bunny. I like that idea. He curls up and falls on his side. Avendable, do I stream in a rigid schedule? Not really. It's flexible, but it is sort of rigid in the sense that I do it daily around 2 to 4 p.m. Sometime around there I start. That's Pacific time. Pacific time. Did I say specific time? Pacific time. Okay, so I can see him taking maybe one frame in the middle of Turk curling up into a ball, but let's get him to his ball-like state first. So I'm going to do a frame. I'm just going to get it. I'm going to push it up here and make him turn into a ball. There you go, Valver. Nice. Let's take like this front bit of him and we'll rotate it around a little bit. The same thing with his tail, we'll tuck it in a bit. This tail needs to move more. Something like that. But this is looking weird with this last quill here. How do I do a rotation like that? It's really easy. Simple Icarus. It's just like you set a selection, right? I'm using this tool here in Photoshop. It's called the selection tool, I think. Oh, it's called the rectangular marquee tool. But anyways, you're selecting pixels basically. So you select some pixels, and then I switch my tool to this one. This is called the select tool, I think. Anyways, it's this tool, right? And that gives you these little gray handle, these little squares and stuff. I could stretch this or whatever. But I'm using, once you get up there, then you put your cursor in the top corner and it turns into a rotate icon and you can just turn it, right? Or you can actually specify your degrees of rotation up here. And then when you're done, you either click the checkbox to just be like, yes, I like that. Or you can click the cancel icon to be like, no, I didn't like that. Sanic! Ah, good call, chimpanzee. Yeah. Oh, you just mean without interpolation? Oh, that's really easy too. You just when you want to rotate something, you just go here to interpolation, nearest neighbor. So instead of it's normally on bicubic or whatever. So you just switch that from bicubic to nearest neighbor, and then it does this beautiful, nice rotation for you guys. And if anybody's like, let's see, I'll show the difference on the stream so that people know what the hell we're talking about. So like if I have this bit of block of pixels and I want to rotate it and I have bicubic rotation on, see how it just messes everything up and it suddenly is no longer look like pixel art? Because it uses aliasing, or it's not aliasing, but bicubic interpolation, which blends all those pixels and makes it look like garbage like this. But if instead, if you use nearest neighbor, it's going to use the exact pixels instead, or the closest approximation it can. So I hope that made sense there. I'm going to just hand do these this last little quill on the bottom. It didn't quite look good. Ah, that's a cool idea, Valware. Right, yeah, I think it's about how he'll look when he's in a ball. Maybe change. Well, I'm gonna make this last quill a little bit nicer though. Yeah, that's good. He's evil, right? Kind of, but kind of not. The enemies, this is the overworld, right? This game has the overworld and an underworld, like, lots of levels and dungeons and tombs and things like that. So enemies on the overworld in this game are meant to be sort of like natural, they're more natural, and the enemies inside the underworld are more evil and like vampire-ish and, like, you know, monster-y. These are more of, like, actual creatures that are somewhat just sort of against you, but not necessarily. So they're sort of in between. They're not really that evil. Simple Icarus, what's the game? This game's called Songbringer. How big's my team? It's just me. I make the music, I make the art, I make the code. How many hours a day do I spend making it? Anywhere from 8 to 12, at least. You know, more like 10 to 12 on average. Yeah, perhaps there. Cool, man. Yeah, okay, so one frame I'm thinking in the middle of this, these two frames. So he goes like digit and like turns into, so he starts here, right? This is him kind of like, actually this frame might be okay. No, let's make him curl a little bit more. So I'm just gonna rotate his face and stuff a little bit. That's a cool idea. A hell porcupine? Yeah, that's true. If there ever is any actual profit, I will be making that. It is! It's Sonic! Sanic! The blue version. Yeah, we need a blue version of this guy to make him Sanic. I'm totally down. I love Sanic. Sanic is great. But he needs to look like really bad. He needs to listen to be really bad art to be Sanic. So we'll tuck his tail in a little bit too. Yes. It's Sonic the Porcupine. Yeah. There, back to that. Okay, that's pretty good too, right? About like that, where, okay, this is one frame. He starts off here. He goes to this frame. Seems to be more like that. And then this last frame. I'm just lining all these up on top of each other for a second. Okay, there. So we've got this where he's like in a ball. All right, so if he curls up, let's make him first curl up into a ball and then fall on his side so that he kind of is not a dangerous entity anymore. But later on, I may actually make him stay like this at this frame where he's still a dangerous entity that will hurt you if you step on him. Nice, right on. Now it's Afro Sonic. Yeah. Okay, so let's do a few more frames. Another one, let's make him start his quill. Like, if he falls over on his side, he's going to get kind of a darker belly, and his quills are going to start disappearing. It's easy to make dying animations because you can make all your pixels look like crap and it actually works. You know, you don't need to make things look perfect at all. You can leave it really dirty and just horrible and it looks better for a dying animation, which is great. It's one of the easiest animations you can do. Yeah, that looks alright. Something like that. It's sort of a middle frame there. Yeah, boss veteran foe type, sure. Why the name Songbringer? It started from the plot of the game. So the plot of the game was originally about musicians. They were intergalactic musicians that went around the galaxy and they played their music and stuff. And they got entwined in this whole plot where they actually had to save this planet. And they actually saved the planet by playing their music. So hence the name Songbringer. But I changed the plot to make it a little more epic and stuff. And I kept the name Songbringer because I liked it a lot. And so I named the ship Songbringer. So the ship you see in the video, right? If you guys haven't seen the a lot of you guys here are new to this game. So I'm gonna post a link to the video. Or I'll just here, you can see the video on songbringer.com. It's easier. So if you click this play icon on Songbringer, you'll see the ship. Actually, I'll just play it here. Here is the ship. Right, so this is Songbringer the ship. It's like a spaceship that flies around the galaxy. It has a bunch of people on the party all the time. That's all they do. They party and they look for planets to go party on. So hence the name Songbringer kind of still works. Was it? It probably was. Okay, and then one more frame where he's all the way on his back, like exposing his belly. Bring in these quills a little bit too. Oh, hole. Oh, so I was wondering. I'm glad you clarified that. Thanks, man. Okay, so you're using GLFW. Okay, and C++. All right. So you're just using straight up GL then. Frame buffer is the exact same size as your window. Huh. Interesting. It's like the frame buffer changes his size to 1 pix. Oh, I get you, right? I can see what's going on with your issue here. Try to change the UV chords. Oh man, I don't know. I don't know. I wish I could help you out with that. I wish I had some. We could just say, "Bam, there's your problem." But I don't know, dude. I would recommend playing with it some more. And if you get to the point where you feel frustrated, take a break, take a good long, break where you just do whatever relaxes you completely. And usually what happens is, your subconscious mind will help you out and you'll figure it out and you come back and be like, "Oh, that was it. Maybe I'll try this." And that leads you along some path and then finally you figure it out. But maybe if that doesn't work, maybe try some other example code. Is there some GL example code of using frame buffers you can find on the internet somewhere? I'm pretty sure there is. I think I was looking around for how to do frame buffers when I first started doing it, and I thought I had to use pure GL, so I think I was looking for that at one point. So I'm sure there's some example code out there, but man, I wish you good luck. I wish I could help you out, but I don't know. All right, there. And so once when he falls away all the way over on his back like this, he's gonna squish down a little bit even more. Like the life just gets out of him. So, all right, let's try this out as an animation. Oh, nice. Right on. Maybe you can help. All right, see you, Pedro. All right, let's hook this up into the all the frames. Starts out around like that. He looks like he's like got electrified. Oops. Oh, yeah, that is the last frame. All right. All right, so the middle frame, like this one here. I think these are a little too tall, these. This too. Nice. Oh, yeah, I hear you. I hear you. Yeah, don't feel like you have to talk code, man, or program. This is game development is a multi-disciplined art form. You know what I mean? You're not only making graphics, you're making code, you're making music as well. So all of those things apply to game development. So if you're going to be a game developer, you might not necessarily be a programmer ever, but you'll still be in the game development world. Pita. How have you been, Pita? How is it? Ciao, bello. Wait, what's the thing you guys taught me to say recently? Was it wasn't ciao bello, was it? All right, this is good enough to try in the game. It's been a minute since I've been in the game, so let's get back there. Export this. Rossupine release in honor of Bob Ross. God rest his soul. Better to kill a tender rabbit. Yeah, make him collect rings. Yeah. There needs to be some gold rings around here. That'd be great. All right, so we're gonna kill the port the Rossupine is going to die now. Hope you all weren't too attached on him. He looks funny when he dies, but I think he's a little too small. His last frame is a tiny bit too much. Yeah, he's a little too small, that last frame. But other than that, I think it's working pretty good. Right, so this frame, cool. That frame, a little too much. Thanks a lot, Salen. Cheers, man. Yeah, this is 11 months into making the game, so hopefully it looks good by now. Yeah, there's already bosses. The James Bond, yeah, the guy that throws the hat. Who throws it? Or throws a shoe? Yeah, there's plenty of bosses, Drunk Champions. Let me show you a boss. There's just way more to this game than you're seeing right now. Because there's, you know, I can't really play the game and make the game. But I do play the game every once in a while. I'll go and actually play it. And you see a lot more of what has been already created. But let me go to a boss. So let's see what one of them looks like. Let's see which one we're finding. This is a procedurally generated Zelda game. This every one of the tiles in this game is procedurally generated based on 6 letters that you give it when you start the game. So the bosses change. You know, the boss changes depending on what seed you used in your world. But, okay, so there's one of the bosses. He's at, that's 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 2, 8. Is that 1? 2, 8, 1? Yeah, 2, 8, 1. Yeah, let me play. I'll play a minute. Yeah, I'll fight this boss or something. Azurus, that I'm glad. I'm glad it's not just me. Yeah, a huge porcupine boss. It collects rings. This is the drop boss guy. I've got some advanced items right now, though. I got like, whoa. I got the fire sword can create these fire enemies like this. But this is the drop boss guy. You can tell I need to work on the game a little bit because there's diagonal movement now, but I haven't tested that with the swords yet. So I need to get the swords so they look better when it's diagonal. This boss is really easy to fight right now, and he shouldn't be so easy. It's a real problem. I need to make this guy better and like harder to fight and stuff. More, less predictable. He's a really, really predictable enemy. Oh, now he's getting down to his last bits of health. There's a lot more to these dungeons than you're seeing right here. Right? I just warped the player right into the very last room. But there's a lot more to these dungeons. Oh no, am I locked in? Oh, I think there's some bug. Oh, it let me go this way. That works. So, yeah, that's just one of the rooms in this dungeon. Like, there's a lot more. There's entire dungeons. Imagine Zelda 1. Oh, bug. Yeah, I changed a lot of these behaviors, so that's why the bug's just in there now. But yeah, you get the point, right? This is what this game is kind of like. How do I read the files of behavior tree? I use Valtry. I wrote this thing to parse these text files over the behavior trees, right? These are the behavior trees. I wrote this and I released it on GitHub. So it's called Valtry. Let's see if I can copy paste this link, right? Yeah, some of these dungeons, some of these bosses are actually going to be mobs. Like, it's instead of fighting a boss, you're going to fight like a 99 different enemies or something crazy. Nice, right on. What's up, Boogie? A wild cinder block boss? Yes. Oh, that's cool too, Azurus. That's a good idea. I like both these, right? He definitely needs more. He needs something else to make him less, like, easy to fight. Oh, it jumped towards the player too? That's a good idea. Yes, yeah, I use the electric drum thing. That doesn't make music. It's just a MIDI controller. This is just a MIDI controller. This thing, like, you press it and it produces a MIDI note, and then you need a software program to translate that MIDI note into something, right? So you create an instrument in your program. This thing is just plays that software instrument or whatever. And the program I use to make music is called Ableton. I'm not going to run it right now because sometimes it messes with the stream. But I use Ableton Live. But there's many other programs and stuff. What's up, Brewbuck? Grewbuck? So did I export this? I think I did. Did I not? I don't know. Wait. This is supposed to be 0.1. So I got to remove Rossi Pine, release. Now let's export this again and then see if it looks a little bit better now. And I think I'm getting close to the being done with the stream, you guys. Yeah, I'm at 2 hours already. So I think this is going to be the last time I run the game. But I got one enemy done today. That's pretty good. Yesterday I got two done, which is even better, but... one enemy is pretty good for one stream, I think. So let's see if this guy looks better when he dies now. I have to warp the player back to where we were, which was, I think, 12-4-0. You just got here. So I got 2 more hours to go. Oh man, I wish I was one of those guys that could do 24-hour streams, but I don't know. I don't know if I could do that. I'll try a 24-hour stream or something, but that sounds pretty hardcore to me. These guys are kind of hard, actually, with their diagonal shooting projectiles. Yeah, that looks a little better. With him just one more pixel tall. I kind of like how he falls over like that. What happened to this guy? He's disappeared. Yeah, that'll work. All right, man. One enemy done this stream. It's pretty good. But, oh, you know what? His quills are going to be a whole nother thing. I need to do a different projectile for his quills. And that's going to take a while as well, so he's not quite done. But oh well. Oh, right? Are they? I've seen one guy do his, but I don't know if they are productive or not. Wait, so it didn't notify you again? But it didn't notify you yesterday, right? And I was under game development yesterday. I'm not sure if it has to do with the category or not, but... So tomorrow I'll try being creative again as a category, and then if it doesn't let you know, definitely let me know and I'll try going back to game dev or something. What's up, Useless Sniper? That's it for today's stream, you guys. I made one new enemy. He's this, it's called the Rossi Pine, the Bob Rossi Pine. He's in honor of Bob Ross. But that's it for today's stream. I'll be back tomorrow. I stream daily, usually 5 to 7 days a week I'm streaming, and it's usually 2 to 4 p.m. Pacific time that I start. And if you just joined the stream, this game's called Songbringer. It's coming out in 2016, and it's a procedurally generated Zelda-like game, so you can play a different world every time you play it, if you want. So see you guys.